Tara Jacobson, Marketing Artfully. Today, I'm going to show you something that once you see it, you're going to be like, oh my goodness, what an easy thing to do. But until you figure it out, it's not so easy. So, one of the things about making pins or any kind of thing in Canva is it's kind of dorky going through your fonts. So, you wind up using, or at least I wind up using, all the same fonts over and over again. So, for example, if I were to take this and go to text and say add a heading and I'm trying to design something, I like Impact. It's my favorite font and it's loaded up as the one that always comes up first. Avant-Garde is something I use all the time. Austin, I use all the time. And so, what winds up happening is all my stuff, especially when you're trying to make all different kinds of pins, winds up looking like all your other stuff. So, that is not good. But I wanted to show you a really cool way that you could organize your fonts. And this is what I did here is I have them all organized and I put them at the start of one of my templates. And I'm going to show you tomorrow how to make templates for your Canva. But today I'm going to show you how to get your fonts organized like this and then some keys for how to do it, okay? So first off, you're going to open any kind of design. So if say you want to do your Pinterest, right? I do lots of Pinterest. Okay, blank pin. Then you're going to say, I want to add a text block, add a heading. And you're gonna say what it is. So this is the Impact font. You can see that right here. So you're gonna say Impact font. And then you're gonna click on that font and pick Option or Control on a PC. And you're gonna pull it, or you could click Copy, 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 Command C, Command V, Command C, Command V. Because you want lots of these. You're going to be using lots of these. You can just stack them all up down here. I want all but one of these chosen. Okay, so we know Impact is one of is our first one, right? So now let's go to the next one that I like. Okay, and we're going to come over here. Avant, it's okay. I like also avocado. Avocado. Okay, so then we're going to do this. And we're going to make it avocado. Okay, and now you see it's that font, right? And then you're going to come over here and you're going to do the same thing again. What do we got? Best friends. This is kind of a, they call it a comic font. So that's a good one. All right. And then let's do this real quick. Bilingual is a great one. It is a what is called a serif font. It's more old-fashioned, right? All of these are very modern. They're sans serif, no little feet on them. Serif means little feet on them. And so they're very modern. But when you're doing something, when you're building a pin or anything, a lot of times you like to have a fancy font and a plain font. Or serif font and a sans serif font. So we're gonna start lining these guys up. Okay. Now I want to figure out some of my ones that are a little funky monkey. So Friday is a really good kind of funky bold one. So fry. Okay, here's a tip. So I always try to do them up and down, right? So I'm gonna type the first character in caps and then lowercase. So this is Friday. So this is uppercase, lowercase, but this one doesn't have a lowercase. So what I do is I put it over here because I need to know the ones that have upper and lower cases. I need some more funky. I do have actually Funky Monkey, I think, but I need, oh, here's a good one. Love sucks. Let's see if it has an upper and lower. It does not, but it's kind of cool. It's hard to see, but it has a dotted line through it. So that's really cool. But we're going to put it over here because it doesn't have an upper and lower, just an upper. And then we're going to get another one. Let's see, do we have any more funky ones? Oh, that's a good one. This is, let's see what happens, Grace and Oliver. It's got a cool ampersand, but it does not have a lowercase. We're going to put it on this side, right over here. Get another one. Let's see, what do we have? Ooh, hello life. This is a cool one. Hello life. Okay. So what I did then is I really sorted them according to what they are. So I put the heavy fonts together at the top. So a lot of times, here, I'll show you. When you're working on your templates, you want to pair a heavy font or a funky font with a plain font. You want to have huge text and then some kind of little fun call-out text. You want a sans-serif font with a scripty font, right? That's what causes contrast in your pins or any of your designs. So you really want to make sure that you know which of your fonts are kind of plain and which are fancy. So then I would say I would do my plain sans-serif font, my plain font, and then start to get into the funkier ones, right? And let's go back to mine. So that's, now that you know what we're looking at, right? That's what I did here. So on this right hand, from here on, Travel Sans On, are the ones that do not have lowercase letters. And then these ones are my heavy fonts. So those are the ones I go to all the time for like the heavy, easy to see on the internet, large text. Playtime's a little funky. And then my scripty fonts. And then my boop, boop, boop. And then my funky ones are here at the end, right? Those I'm gonna use very judiciously, because it's hard for Pinterest to read them, it's hard for humans to read them, but they're always good to have a couple funky ones. And then these are the only uppercase ones. So again, we have our sans serifs and our heavier ones. There's a good one. And then we have lighter sans serifs. Then we have funky ones. I actually use these ones all the time. I use Cedar, but Mr. Bear and Sunshine are really good ones too. And then I have been using, I like Silencio, and I like Whale because Canva doesn't have a drop, doesn't have an outline, but this one comes with an outline, which is very cool. So in case you were wondering, I got these at Creative Market. Let's see, do we have the one I got? So I got mine at Creative Market, and all I did was search for font bundle. Now I will have a link to that. I will have a link to Creative Market in my description. And then the one that I got is this one. So if you like some of the fonts that you saw, now some of them were already fonts I had, but if you like this one, this is like a huge font bundle. It'll really get you started. And the bonus is that it's $19, right? So you're not paying $19 a font, you're paying $19 for a huge bundle of fonts. So hopefully that helps. Start organizing your fonts and start making more interesting pins. Tara Jacobson, Marketing Artfully.